Now we start our last point of derivative chapter of 12, class 12. Now we start higher order derivative. Out of this, we have completed derivative of composite function, logarithmic differentiation, parametric derivative, derivative of implicit function, derivative of inverse trigonometric function. And now, last topic is higher order derivative. So firstly we analysis or firstly we discuss what does mean by higher order derivative. If there is any function y is equal to f of x, is a differentiable function of x, then dy by dx is equal to f dash of x is nothing but the first order derivative. First order derivative, which is also denoted by y dash or y. If we differentiate this first order derivative again with respect to x, it gives second order derivative. That means second order derivative. So for that, what we have to do? We have to differentiate this first order derivative with respect to x. So it should be dy by dx of d by dx of dy by dx, and definitely it is written as d2y by dx square, or f double dash of x, or y double dash, or y. Now if we differentiate this second order derivative with respect to x again, it gives third order derivative. Third order derivative. For that we have to differentiate. For that we have to differentiate d2y by dx square with respect to x. So what we get after differentiating d2y by dx square with respect to x, we get d3y by dx cube, that means third order derivative, which is also denoted by f triple dash of x, y triple dash, and y cube. Next, we differentiate this third order derivative again with respect to x, and we get fourth order derivative. Like in the same way, if we differentiate the given corresponding derivatives or identities, we get nth order derivative. Nth order derivative. Now, how we represent it? We represent it in the form of dny by dx raised to n is equal to y raised to n or yn, including second, third, fourth, fifth, dash dash up to nth order derivative, or our higher order derivative. And in this particular lecture, we are studying second order derivative. So let me start our point, second order derivative. Question is that find d2y by dx square of the following. That means we have to find the second order derivative with respect to x. So we start with the first example. First example is, if y is equal to x cube into log x. Find its second order derivative. So what we have to do? Firstly, we analysis which steps we have to follow. So firstly, consider y is equal to x cubed into log of x. We start with the first example. What we have to do? Firstly, differentiate y with respect to x. And again, this first order derivative differentiate with x, we get second order derivative. So we have to find d2y by dx square by differentiating given y two times. So what we can do? Firstly, we find first order derivative. So our solution starts with differentiating y with respect to x. The left hand side we get dy by dx. What about the right hand side? Right hand side is nothing but the multiplication of two functions. First function is x cube and second function is log x. To differentiate given function, we have to analyze some points. Which thing we have to analyze? We have to analyze whether the given functions are standard or composite. If you observe here, x cube is polynomial function, which is standard function. Log x is also standard function, logarithmic function. That means we have given two different functions which are in the standard form. Now what is the next point of analysis? If there is a multiplication sign in between these two functions, we have to use multiplication rule. So main point is that use the multiplication rule, simplify it, we get first order derivative. And we don't have to use any chain rule for the composite rule. So what about the right hand side? We are using multiplication rule for the first order derivative. What is the multiplication rule? Multiplication rule is as, keep first function as it is into derivative of second function plus second function as it is into derivative of second function. So what is the first function? So I put x cube, I consider x cube as the first function and log x as a second function. So what is the next line? X cube, first function as it is into derivative of log of x is nothing but 1 upon x plus second function as it is, that means log of x as it is. And what is the derivative of? What is the derivative of x cube? This is nothing but 3x squared by using formula of x raised to n. Now, this is the first step, or up till we completed first order derivative. Now, if it is possible, simplify it. I think we can cancel 1x from denominator to numerator. So first step is converted into x square plus 3 is constant term, similarly x cube is x square is there into log of x. Out of this we can take x square common from the two terms, so we get x square into in bracket 1 plus 3 log of x as first order derivative. But actually we have to find second order derivative, and as per our analysis we have to differentiate this dy by dx with respect to x again, as we have to find the second order derivative. So our next line is differentiate dy by dx with respect to x. What we get? The left hand side we get dy dx of dy by dx. So dy dx of dy by dx is nothing but d2y by dx square. This is the left hand side from our previous one knowledge. And what about the right hand side? Now if we again observe dy by dx, this is the first function, and this is second function. So observe once again, in dy by dx we have two different functions. First is x square and second is 1 plus 3 log of x, and in between these two functions there is multiplication. That means we have to use a multiplication rule here for the derivative of next article. So what we get, we are using the same rule as we have already discussed. We have to use multiplication rule. So start with the multiplication rule. What is the multiplication rule? First function remains as it is, so x square as it is, into derivative of second functions, mean derivative of this function. Out of this, derivative of 1 is 0, plus 3 is a constant term, it remains as it is, and derivative of log x is nothing but x, plus, now second function remains as it is. Second function means 1 plus 3 log x into derivative of x square, but derivative of x square is nothing but 2x by using the formula of x raised to n. This is nothing but n into x raised to n minus 1, so derivative of x square is nothing but 2x, and the procedure of derivative is completed here. Now anyhow simplify this given identity and write your solution. So what we can do, if we multiply x square to inner quantity, it gives x square 3 divided by x, but out of this we can cancel one of the x from the numerator. So for the first term we get 3x plus, now multiply 2x to the inner quantity, it gives 2x plus 6 log of x. So on the next line we can put 3x after multiplying x square to the inner quantity plus 2x into 1, 2x plus 3 into 2x, that means 6x into log of x. Out of this, these two terms are plain terms. After adding these two terms we get 5x plus 6x log of x, and this is nothing but our second order derivative, that means d2y by dx square. So we get final solution of this first one example as 5x plus 6x into log of x. I start with second example. Second example is, if y is equal to x raised to x, then find its second order derivative. For that, we firstly recall what we have to do. Firstly, the analysis what we have to do. If the function is like in this way, y is equal to x raised to x, find its first order derivative, that means dy by dx. Again, differentiate dy by dx such that we get d2y by dx square. Now, this is the analysis. This is the first point. Now, second point. If you observe this y is equal to x raised to x, this function is not a standard function. This function is not a composite function. And if you observe this, we get that this function is function raised to function. Now, if any function given in the form of function raised to function, we have to differentiate such examples by using logarithmic differentiation. And for such examples, we take log on both sides, differentiate it, we get dy by dx. So second point of our analysis is that key, we have to differentiate this by taking log on both sides. So our two points are most important points here. First is find dy by dx by using logarithmic differentiation. After that, again differentiate this with respect to x such that we get d2y by dx square. Now let me start. So we start with the solution. If y is equal to x raised to x, and mention this equation as a Roman part second. Now as per our discussion, take log on both sides and differentiate this. So taking log on both sides, what we get? The left hand side, we can write it as log of y is equal to log of x raised to x. Now if you observe log of x raised to x, and if we memorize all the rules of log, we can say that we can apply here exponent rule. Which one rule? Exponent rule of log. Exponent rule is that if there is any identity log of a raised to k, it may be written as k into log of a. So if you observe this log of x raised to x, so it may be written as x into log of x. Exponent rule of log. So if you observe this log y is equal to x into log of x, now we differentiate this with respect to x. Differentiating y with respect to x, what we get, guys? If you observe the left hand side, this is nothing but the log of y, which is the composite function. Why this is composite function? If this is log x, then definitely it must be a standard function. But instead of x, if there is another function of x, it becomes composite. So we differentiate log y with respect to x by using chain rule of composite rule. So what is the derivative of log of y? Derivative of log of y is nothing but 1 upon y into dy by dx is equal to, what about the right hand side? If you observe the right hand side, this is nothing but the multiplication of two functions, x as a first function and log x as a second function. So for the derivative of second function, we have to apply the multiplication rule. What is the multiplication rule? First function as it is into derivative of second function plus second function as it is into derivative of first function. This is the rule of multiplication rule. So we start with the multiplication rule, first function as it is into derivative of log of x. Derivative of log of x is nothing but 1 upon x plus log of x as it is as a second function into derivative of first function, means 1 with respect to x is 1, by multiplication rule of a derivative. Now if we simplify the right hand side, it is x gets cancelled with this x, so we get 1 plus log of x. And if you observe the left hand side, 1 upon y is there, but from all these calculations we have to find only dy by dx. So what is our next step? Very easy, shift this y from the left hand side to the right hand side, and then we get dy by dx. So what should be the dy by dx? Dy by dx is nothing but y into bracket 1 plus log of x, and definitely we are replacing the value of y from first identity as x raised to x into in bracket 1 plus log of x. So this is nothing but the dy by dx, but we have to find d2y by dx square. So if we name this identity, so remark this identity as a Roman part second. Now what we can do for the second derivative, to find the second order derivative, we have to differentiate dy by dx again with respect to x. So our next line is differentiating dy by dx with respect to x given. If we observe the left hand side, this may be written as dy dx of dy by dx. But our previous one discussion, it may be written as d2y by dx square. This is nothing but. Now, to differentiate this identity, we have to differentiate this one. But in between these two functions, we have a multiplication. So, to find the derivative of this function, that means second order derivative, we are using multiplication rule here. So, what is the multiplication rule? I will simultaneously explain the multiplication rule and write the same equations. So, what is the multiplication rule? First function as it is. So, x raised to x remains as it is into derivative of second function. So, second function's derivative is same. Once the derivative 0 plus derivative of log of x is nothing but 1 upon x. Now plus second function as it is. So what is the second function? This is nothing but 1 plus log of x into derivative of x raised to x. And this is nothing but the multiplication rule. Now, out of this, I think we can simplify this term. It remains as it is. But what is the derivative of x raised to x? मला असं वाटतंय x raised to x चं derivative आपण already इथे equation second मध्ये find out केलेलं आहे. ते आपण इथे replace करणार. So, what we get next step, we get as x raised to x divided by x plus into in bracket 1 plus log x as it is and derivative of x raised to x from second identity is nothing but x raised to x into in bracket 1 plus log of x, and we are taking this identity from second. We are replacing the value of this derivative from second. So what will be the next line? If we observe carefully, we can take x raised to x from first and second term. From the both two terms, we can take common x raised to x as a common. So x raised to x remains as a common. And into in bracket, we get 1 upon x plus log of, I think 1 plus log of x is there. So we have to write here 1 plus log of x, and same terms occur, so x square. And this is nothing but the d2y by dx square. So our corresponding and required d2y by dx square is nothing but x raised to x into in bracket 1 divided by x plus log of x its square bracket completely. So I will repeat once again, what is the procedure to find the second order derivative? First of all, find its first order derivative with respect to x, and again differentiating, we can find d2y by dx square. Now let's we get to the third example. So we start solution of our third example. If you observe the board, we have given that if x is equal to 2at square, now we are solving this one example third, which thing we have given that as x is equal to 2at square and y is nothing but 4at, and we have to find the second order derivative of this example. मला असं वाटतंय की हे प्रत्येक एक्झाम्पल स्टार्ट करण्यापूर्वी मी प्रत्येक वेळेस रिकॉल करतोय की आपण कुठल्या कुठल्या टाईपचे डायरेक्टिव्ह अगोदर पाहिले आहेत. याच्यापूर्वी आपण डायरेक्टिव्ह पाहिलंय कंपोजिट फंक्शनचं डायरेक्टिव्ह, लॉगरिथमिक डिफरन्सिएशन, derivative of parametric function, derivative of inverse trigonometric function, derivative of implicit function, and now we are studying derivative, higher order derivative. But if you observe the given example, x and y both are defined separately. That means this is the parametric function where t is a parameter. So how we can differentiate it? And not only one time, we have to differentiate it two times. So we have to differentiate this example by using derivative of parametric function. Since y is a parameter and x and y are defined separately. So x and y separately defined ke liye t available. So by using derivative of parametric function, we can say that dy by dx is nothing but dy by dt divided by dx by dt. So for that, which thing we have to apply to find actually d2y by dx square? If we observe the given identity, we have to analyze two or three points here. First point is find its derivative, that means dy by dx by using parametric function. Then differentiate it with respect to x and find d2y by dx square. That means in first step we have to find it with respect to t. But at the second time, I will mention this point once again. At the second point, we have to differentiate it with respect to x. At this particular time, most of the students make a silly mistake. They differentiate it with respect to t, not with respect to x. So this is the analysis. Now we briefly solve this given example. What should we have to do? Actually, we have to find dy by dx by using parametric derivative of parametric functions. So as we know, dy by dx is equal to dy by dt divided by dx by dt. And this is the first equation. Now, what we can find derivative of y with respect to t? For this, consider y is equal to 4at and differentiate y with respect to t. So what we get? Actually we get dy by dt, and this is nothing but 4a constant term, so it remains as it is. And what is the derivative of t with respect to t? I think it should be 1. So dy by dt is nothing but 4a. Now consider x. X is nothing but 2at square. So let me check once again. X is nothing but 2at square and y is nothing but 4at. So differentiate this x with respect to t, and from this we get dx by dt. Dx by dt is equal to 2a constant term, so it remains as it is. And what is the derivative of t square? So it should be 2t. So value of dx by dt is nothing but 2 into 2, 4at. So what we do now? Now put this dy by dt and dx by dt in previous one identity, that means dy by dx. So we get dy by dx is equal to dy by dt. The value of dy by dt from this one, this is nothing but 4a, divided by the value of dx by dt from this identity is 4at. So if we mention this identity as Roman second and this identity is Roman third, so whatever next line, we get dy by dx from equation from second and third. from second and third. If we observe this, we can cancel 4a from numerator and denominator, and we get dy by dx as 1 upon 2. Up till this, we completed it, or we have find the value of dy by dx. But actually, we have to find d2y by dx square. That's why we have to differentiate this dy by dx again with respect to x. So our next slide is differentiating dy by dx with respect to x again. So what we get from the left hand side? To the left hand side, we get that d by dx of dy by dx is equal to, this is nothing but the dy by dx square is equal to. Now, what is the derivative of 1 upon t with respect to x? And this is the main point where most of the students make a silly mistakes. Actually, our statement is that we have to differentiate it with respect to x, not with respect to t. So be careful at this particular step. So this is nothing but 1 upon t. So it should be shifted to the numerator. So it becomes t raised to minus 1. T raised to minus 1 is differentiated with respect to x. But it is the function, it is the composite function. So its derivative is minus into t raised to minus 2 if we use the formula of x raised to n, and by using chain rule we are again multiplying it with dt by dx. And why its derivative is in this form? Since here 1 upon t, if we replace here 1 upon t in the form of t raised to minus 1. Now it is easy to understand. What is the derivative of t raised to minus 1? T raised to minus 1 is the derivative as nare minus 1 into t raised to minus 1 minus 1. So it should be minus 2, t raised to minus 2. Now, what is the next line? To the left hand side, we can write it as d2y by dx square. Minus sign remains as it is. T raised to minus 2 remains as it is. But we don't know the value of dt by dx. So what we can do? So we just observe which value we have already obtained from the first, second or third identity. If you observe second one, we get dy by dt. Third one, dx by dt. But actually we want the value of dt by dx. So if we write dt by dx as a reciprocal identity, as dx by dt, what we get? Now we can replace the value of dx by dt from identity third. This should be nothing but 4at. So replace the value of dx by dt. It gives minus 1 upon t square, may be written as 1 upon t square. And what about the value of dx by dt? I think it should be 4at. And we are replacing the value from equation number 3. From 3rd, we are replacing the value of this dx by dt. So the value of dx by dt is nothing but the 4at. So now we simplify our next point as minus as it is upon 4a as it is into pq. So our second order derivative is nothing but minus 1 upon 4a tq.